Hi, welcome back. In this video session, we are going to learn about the lower respiratory tract. So we know the regions of lower respiratory tract. Lower respiratory tract comprises larynx, trachea, and the lungs form the lower respiratory tract. These are the regions of our lower respiratory tract. So let's begin with the larynx. So first part of our lower respiratory tract is larynx. You know larynx. This larynx or voice box or sound box. See, this larynx is a cartilaginous box. This portion is larynx, the first beginning of our lower respiratory tract, larynx. It is a cartilaginous box. So why it is called as a cartilaginous box? Because this larynx is supported by 9 pieces of cartilages. It is supported by 9 pieces of cartilages. Hence, it is a cartilaginous box because it is supported by 9 pieces of cartilages. Then, the different types of cartilages of larynx are. Generally, there are 2 types of cartilage in larynx. Cartilages of larynx are grouped into 3. Unpaired cartilages. And 3. Paired cartilages. So this larynx is supported by total 9 pieces of cartilage. They are 3 unpaired cartilages and 3 paired cartilages. See, suppose this is the larynx region. And this is the anterior view of larynx and this is the posterior view of larynx. In this diagram we can see these cartilages of larynx. There are total 9 pieces of cartilage and here the unpaired cartilages of larynx. The unpaired cartilages of larynx are. One is epiglottis. Second one is thyroid cartilage. Third one is cricoid cartilage. These are the 3 unpaired cartilages of larynx. So the unpaired cartilages of larynx, they are epiglottis. Then thyroid cartilage, and last one is cricoid cartilage. These are the 3 unpaired cartilages of larynx. So 3 unpaired cartilages, they are epiglottis, thyroid cartilage and cricoid cartilage form the unpaired cartilage. And 3 are paired cartilages. These paired cartilages of larynx, mostly these paired cartilages can be seen in the posterior view. See, a pair of arytenoid cartilage. So, these paired cartilages are first on a pair of arytenoid cartilage. Next, a pair of cuneiform cartilage. Last one, a pair of corniculate cartilage. These are the 3 paired cartilages of larynx. So this larynx is supported by total 9 pieces of cartilage. They are 3 unpaired and 3 paired cartilages. Unpaired cartilages are epiglottis, thyroid cartilage and cricoid cartilage. Then paired cartilages are arytenoid cartilage, cuneiform cartilage and corniculate cartilage. These form the paired cartilages of larynx. So it is a cartilaginous box. Okay. And here, this epiglottis, we know the opening of larynx is called as glottis. This is the opening of larynx, glottis. This glottis is guarded by this elastic cartilage. This elastic cartilage in a flap is epiglottis. Then next is thyroid cartilage. These are the largest hyaline cartilages. hyaline type. These are the largest hyaline cartilage in larynx, this thyroid cartilage. And this thyroid cartilage, actually it covers the ventral and side of this larynx. So ventral part and side of this larynx are covered by this or supported by this thyroid cartilage. And here, a prominence from this thyroid cartilage. This prominence from this thyroid cartilage called laryngeal prominence. This prominence from this thyroid cartilage called laryngeal prominence or Adam's apple. Laryngeal prominence or the Adam's apple. This is thyroid cartilage. Then third one is cricoid cartilage. This cricoid cartilage seen on the base of this larynx. See, this like this watch, this cricoid is a ring of cartilage on the base of this larynx. It's a ring of cartilage on the base of this larynx. So we can this cricoid cartilage can be seen in both anterior as well as posterior view because it is a ring of cartilage at the base of this larynx. Okay, so these are the three unpaired cartilages of larynx. And the paired cartilage can be seen in the posterior surface. They are arytenoid, cuneiform and corniculate cartilage. Okay. So these are the cartilages of larynx. Hence this larynx is a cartilaginous box. Then this larynx is also known as voice box or sound box. This larynx is the voice box or sound box in man. Because inside this larynx, the inferior wall of larynx, suppose this is the inferior wall of larynx, in a cross section, this is larynx, this is the inferior wall. In the inferior wall of larynx are two pairs of folds. Inferior wall of larynx are two pairs of folds. Two pairs of folds are present. So two pairs of folds are found in the interior wall of larynx. And these folds stretches from these two folds stretches from thyroid cartilage in front and to arytenoid cartilage on the back side. So this pairs of folds stretches from thyroid cartilage in front and arytenoid cartilage in back. So it extends from thyroid cartilage to arytenoid cartilage. This pairs of folds in the inferior wall of larynx. And among these two pairs of folds, the outer pair of folds were called vestibular folds. So two pairs of folds in the inferior wall of larynx. And this outer pair of folds are known as vestibular folds. And the inner folds called as vocal cords. This inner folds called as vocal cords. See, these vocal cords are responsible for producing sound in man. Vibrations in this vocal cord produce voice. This voice producing vocal cords are found inside the larynx. Hence, this larynx is called as the sound box. Because only this larynx have the sound producing structure vocal cords. So these vocal cords are a pair of folds found in the inferior wall of larynx. Vibrations of vocal cord, particularly vibration of vocal cord during exhalation. The vibrations of vocal cord during exhalation produce the different types of phonation and voice in man. So these vocal cords are responsible for production of sound. These vocal cords are found inside the larynx, hence this larynx called as voice box or sound box. And this vocal cord, they are predominantly composed of yellow elastic connective tissue. They are predominantly formed of yellow elastic connective tissue in addition to squamous as well as smooth muscles. They are predominantly composed of the yellow elastic connective tissue. So this is the beginning of our lower respiratory tract larynx. So this part is larynx. This larynx is a cartilaginous box which helps in the production of sound, hence the name voice box or sound box. Okay. Then what is the lining of this larynx? The
His larynx is
lined by stratified non-keratinized squamous. Stratified non-keratinized squamous above the vocal cord, the region above the vocal cord. So in the larynx, suppose here this is vocal cord, the region above the vocal cords are lined by the stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium. So this larynx, that means the part of larynx above the vocal cords are lined by stratified non-keratinized squamous epithelium. But the part of pharynx below this, suppose this is vocal cord, suppose the vocal cord angle. The part of pharynx below the vocal cords are lined by ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium. Ciliated pseudo stratified epithelium. Okay. So this is the larynx region, the beginning of our lower respiratory tract. Okay.